I'm in Sihuas. I'm 700 kilometers away from the border of Ecuador, and the time has come to change from my cart into a backpack. This has been really a wonderful device, and I'd highly recommend if you have a family, if you have an injury and you don't want to be lugging a backpack on your back, or if you just want to be doing a hike and having an easier time about it, I would highly recommend the Monowalker. It has been really good. The reason I decided to go with the Monowalker was because it is versatile, it's really rugged, you can get into areas that are tricky, but above everything else, I needed to carry 40 liters of water with me through the desert, and I obviously can't carry that in a backpack. So that was what really pushed me into getting the cart in the first place. And of course, I had a rambunctious puppy with me who couldn't make 30 kilometers a day, so he spent a lot of time sleeping in the back of this cart. So this has been really hard for me, and I guess I get very nervous about leaving things behind, not being able to get them again, and being in the middle of nowhere and really getting in a pickle. So I've been quite careful with what I've gotten rid of, and I may even drop a few things in the future, we'll see. The thing that I think about most, and what is really tricky right now, is that I'm in Peru and I'm in altitude, so nights can get below 12 in the middle of winter, especially the higher in elevation. I've had to be really careful about my clothing choice, which I have really limited, and considered things like how much food I'm going to need, the distances between town, how much water I'm going to need, and of course I've had to consider things like wombat's pack as well. So I'm going to give you an idea of what I'm carrying and how I've reduced it. So this is the kitchen. This section here are my electronics and repair kit. I have over here, I have my first aid kit and toiletries. This is wombat's kit, which isn't massive by any means. And that has really been downscaled as well, because he was outside the tent for a while when I had a friend walking with me, so I needed to keep him quite warm. And then this is my sleeping system and tent, which has also changed quite significantly between being in a Monowalker and going into a pack. And that actually is more to do with climate and not to do so much with changing into the pack. So what's changed about my kitchen? I've gotten rid of anything that is absolutely not 100% needed. So I had a few spare bottles with me. Originally I had two Nalgenes, and these have been really good because when I was conserving water in the desert, I would pick up whatever had water in it, and if I could reuse it, I would put it back into one of these bottles, and that's been great. They're also really good for water collection. I've gotten rid of any bowls that aren't necessary. My thermos is an absolute luxury item. The reason that I'm carrying it is, again, because of the cold. It's a backup because I've gotten rid of so many clothes that it's going to be something that will just help to keep me warm if I get into that situation. And as soon as I can get rid of this, I will. When I get rid of items, I don't just throw them out. If I can store them for use later, I do. But more so, I really like to find someone who can get a lot of use out of it that wouldn't ordinarily be able to come across these products, and I give it to them, like a local. I have an everything bag. In this bag, I put anything that I want to be able to get my hands on quickly. So I have my electronics, my diary and repair kit in there, and my head torch. In this section here is Wombat's kit. He has a backpack from Roughwear, and I've really scaled this down. Earlier when it was very cold, I had him in a sleeping bag and all sorts of extra items that are really quite heavy. So I've gotten rid of those now, and I'll be able to put my sleeping bag over him should he get cold. I don't want to be putting valuable gear in here that can get wrecked. What I've decided to do is use these 1 liter water sacks and get him carrying 2 liters of water. This is not something that's going to happen immediately. Over the last couple of weeks, I've been having him in this pack, building him up into getting used to the weight. So Wombat will be helping me with carrying loads, but only to what is reasonable for his size and his strength. And I also have a first aid kit for Wombat, which includes some antibiotics and some painkillers, and I have his information for crossing borders with me. I have some shoes which are for first aid use because he's such a tough dog that he hasn't had problems with his paws, but I do check those weekly, and when I'm in town I get a vet to look over him and make sure that he's in good form. This pile here is what I'm getting rid of. So in here there is a fair amount of clothing which has been really difficult to decide about getting rid of because it's going to be cold. I'm passing three more major peaks and it is midwinter. Not getting rid of Wombat, he's staying with me. Getting rid of a sock. And I've changed, this is the sleeping bag that I mentioned earlier that was his. You can see it's big, it's not going to fit into my backpack, and it weighs about 750 grams. It's completely unnecessary now that the climate is warming up. And this is my tent, which I was previously using. I've had this tent for a year, it's served me really well, but now it doesn't, it's not waterproof. Water's coming through from the bottom, it's coming through from the top. It weighs about 2.5 kilos, and it's just one item that I can really cut back on weight, which I really have done. So I have gone from having this tent to this tent. The difference in weight is 500 grams versus 2.5 kilos. And because I'm on my own, I'm really not, and I'm going to be in high winds occasionally, I wasn't particularly comfortable in having this tent used with hiking poles. Plus I don't use hiking poles, so I've got the version in a freestanding form, but I will link you to all of that information later. The other really easy weight saver is what backpack I've chosen to use. This bag is about 2 kilos, and with the panniers that's 4 kilos. So I've gone into this backpack. Again, the information will be linked, but it weighs about, again, 500 grams, whereas my previous backpack was 2 kilos. So after scaling everything down, I have gone from this in my cart to this with my pack. And you can see that it's a big deal. Naturally, this is a quite a big pile, but I have also been getting rid of things as I've been walking through the last couple of towns, and that has made a really big difference. Thanks for watching. If you want to see more, subscribe to the channel. And if you want to throw a cake, some chocolate, a coffee, a dog bone into the fund, you can do so by the link below. If you have any hot tips on how I can get my pack weight down, I actually would really appreciate that because I'm just out here learning on my own. So make sure you put a comment below, or any interesting tip, I'd really appreciate. And otherwise, I'll see you out there.
Hey, how I got you, I never let you go. Oh, now I've got you, I won't let you go. End of the road, baby.